friends. So I'm going to tell you a little story about being a stem reject while I get all of this to happen.
I have this like teeny tiny Brooklyn apartment sink that like gets water everywhere, like a Neutrogena commercial.
I used to love science class until I got to high school chemistry. What I remember most from that class is my teacher yelling molar mass in his exaggerated British accent, and our 1 hour class periods ending with everybody looking around kind of like, what just happened? Was any of that words? Like, I wasn't used to feeling so frustrated in school and like truly not understanding what was going on.
Okay, so the first thing that I'm gonna do is wash my face, and I'm gonna use this micellar cleanser that Glossier makes. I'm like really mad about how much I like it because they're just like so deeply target demoed at me. A micellar cleanser just means that it has these little tiny balls of surfactant molecules hanging out in water. And a surfactant is what helps lift off oil-based things like makeup or sunscreen or just your own face oils off of your skin. But these tend to be pretty gentle, so they won't take all of the oil off of your skin and leave you like desiccated. So that's nice. And at night I will do this 2 times in a row to just like make sure I get all my eye makeup off.
And though I like worked my ass off to figure it out and did well in the class, I wanted to take AP Physics the following year. And at my high school, you had to have your current teacher in that subject sign off on you being able to take AP. So I went in and I asked him to like approve me for AP Physics. And he was like, I'm not quite sure if you're ready, which fine, because I took honors physics instead and struggled my way to a B, but I was up for the challenge and I was denied. And that stuck with me. Like my last semester of high school, I didn't need any more science credits to graduate, so I just didn't take science. Then I went to college, took an environmental physics class to get my necessary credit, which I fucking smashed, by the way. Then I just declared an English major and never took science again. That's a lie. I study science like every day.
Then next I will take a hydrating serum. This is the Hada Labo Premium Lotion. It's got a ton of hyaluronic acid in it and it's like a huge bottle. And hyaluronic acid is a humectant, which means that it will take moisture out of the air or like the deeper layers of your skin that aren't so exposed and just hold them nice and tight close to the top layer of your skin and keep it just like nice and juicy. Then I just want to seal in all of that moisture that I just put on my face so it can't evaporate away as fast as it might usually. And I just use like this really basic drugstore moisturizer. Any like oils, butters, silicones, like petroleum jelly that you might find in a moisturizer exists to prevent that water loss from happening. This one also has ceramides, which are already like made by your skin as part of that oily lipid barrier that it has to protect itself from the outside.
Rewind a second to when I was like 11 and started getting acne. I got whatever Neutrogena face wash everyone gets and the Stridex pads. I think my mom ordered me Proactive at one point. I did all of the things that you're supposed to do and none of it worked. And yet every day after school, I was Googling things like how to get clear skin and how to get clear skin fast and how to get a boy to like you and Kelly Clarkson hair highlights. Only the first two of those are relevant, but what I stumbled on were these like early internet, pre-YouTube, pre-Instagram beauty communities. Most of them were centered around sharing makeup reviews and photos describing eyeshadow techniques, but pretty much every one of them had a subset of people who were like me, who had bad skin and didn't want it to be bad. But oh my God, they knew so much. Like, I started by learning that all of the drugstore zit creams I was using relied on either benzoyl peroxide to kill acne bacteria or salicylic acid to exfoliate your dead skin cells away so they can't hang around too long and block your pores. And then I learned that salicylic acid needs to be between a pH of 3 and 4 to actually work properly, and my clean and clear toner wasn't cutting it.
Because it's morning right now, I'm gonna put on sunscreen. This is a Japanese sunscreen that I like pirate into the US because the US has weird sunscreen politics. Sunscreens work either by absorbing the UV rays and turning them into heat energy or by bouncing them back off
away from your precious, precious face.
And the ones that do the bouncing, which are called physical blockers, tend to be kind of like white, reflective, really ashy looking. So I tend to use the other kind, which are called chemical filters or organic filters. And the chemical filters tend to degrade over time in the light, which, as you can imagine, is a problem for sunscreen. It's why you have to reapply it all the time. But outside of the US, there are filters that tend to hold up a little longer, or they can block UV rays from a broader swath of the UV spectrum. But because our government is like wild and slow and sunscreen is not a polarizing political issue, those filters have not been approved for use in the US yet, even though it's been like 20 or 15 years that they've been in use in other countries. So if you want to get really hardcore into sunscreen, you can import them from Europe or Asia.
In order to convince my mom to buy a different brand online, which in 2003 was a scary place that you went to have your identity thieved, I made a spreadsheet comparing products from 10 major brands with their concentration of salicylic acid, their pH, their price per ounce, and if there were any other red flag ingredients that could make me break out more. She bought the one that I wanted for me because who can say no to a spreadsheet, am I right? Electrified by my victory, I dove in deeper. In the name of fading my acne scars, I learned how to look up peer-reviewed journal articles about dermatology from my local library. And then in high school and college, I learned to read them and understand them better and figure out if they were testing on a lot of human faces or like the inside of a couple rabbit ears. And in my skincare communities, there were a lot of people like me. After college, I started getting paid to write skincare reviews for a beauty blog using all the knowledge I picked up. And turns out that a ton of women and femmes are sick of being sold anti-aging neck cream with Rejuvabright and actually want to know what the shit they're putting on their face. And we want to know if those ingredients are research-backed and at what concentration they're in the product, and if they're stabilized and packaged correctly so that they still work by the time that we get them home from the store, into our bathroom cabinet, and onto our face 2 months later. And to us, figuring out the routine where all of the ingredients work together to meet our goals, whether they're about feeling pretty or staying healthy, feels like a fun, complicated puzzle that we get to work out. If this were nighttime instead of sunscreen, I would put on my retinoid. And retinoids kind of help regulate skin cells all around, so they get them all on the same page as to like how fast they should turn over, how much oil they should produce, how much they should inflame in response to acne bacteria, right? So it's like a therapist for your skin that can be like, you're doing too much and you need to move on and you just need to calm down. Though that would be like awful if that was your actual therapist. There are a ton of different strengths of retinoids because they can also like irritate your skin in the beginning as they're kind of like speeding up your cell turnover. This is just Differin, which if you also went to the dermatologist with a lot of acne as a teen, you might have gotten prescribed to you. It's now available over the counter. It's like 10 bucks. And after that, there are so many categories of product that you could use: AHAs, BHAs, peels, vitamin C serums, essences, but I have really sensitive skin, so I can only really handle like one thing at a time. Like when I started learning about all of these ingredients, I was like, wow, they're all so effective. Let me put them all on my face. And it kind of freaked out. So now I just keep it super simple and that's all I do. This isn't even skincare, by the way. This is just concealer. Now I love writing and the English major that I chose is a perfectly useful and important field of study. But what if someone had seen my pH spreadsheet that I made in middle school and went, wow, you could totally be a chemist. How different would my life look now? So when we ask questions like, why aren't more girls interested in STEM? I just want to shout that they are. You're just telling them that they're not ready. You just don't think that the kinds of science that they're engaging with already in their everyday lives are science because girls like them. I'm gonna leave some links in the description to some cosmetic chemistry communicators who go into much more detail and explain things more thoroughly than I did if you wanna get in this rabbit hole with me. So tell me in comments, are you scientifically inclined? And if not, what brought you away from the sciences? Also, if you just wanna talk about skincare products, please tell me what you like to use. I am always down to talk about products. All right, if you like this video, share it with someone who you think might like it, and I will see you soon. Bye.